Ooh. See the light. Good evening to all parishioners and visitors of St. Anne's online Easter Vigil celebration. Welcome. This mother of all vigils is the greatest and most noble of all solemnities. On this holy night, the Church keeps watch, celebrating the resurrection of Christ in the sacraments and awaiting his return in glory. It is the turning point of the Triduum, the Passover of the New Covenant, which marks Christ's passage from death to life. Tonight, we will be omitting certain parts of the celebration, the blessing of the fire, baptism, and confirmation. Let us begin the celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, on this sacred night in which our Lord Jesus passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters, scattered throughout the world, to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Christ, yesterday and today. The beginning and the end. The Alpha and the Omega. All time belongs to him, and all ages. To him, glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ the Lord Guard us. And protect us. Amen. The light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
Exalt, let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad, as glory floods her, ablaze with the light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of His glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, His Son, His only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wipe clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorpost of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace, joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us. Oh, love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. O happy fault, that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. Oh, truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, the night shall be as bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me, and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor. a fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by the sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you, that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance and let it mingle with the light of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets. Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain, has shed its peaceful light on humanity, and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild things of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created man in his image. In the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." God said, "See, I have given you every plant-yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food." And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord,
send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they die, and they return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit of life, they are created in your sight. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. May his glory last for all time. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him will be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who are wonderful in ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of ages, Christ as Passover has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said, "But you lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the children of Israel may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I shall gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots and his chariot drivers." The angel of God, who was going before the Israelite army, moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back with a strong east wind all night and turned the sea into dry land. and the waters were divided. The children of Israel went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of the Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into a panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the children of Israel, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers, the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the children of Israel walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great word that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. The prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went in out after her with tambourines and with dancing. Moses and the children of Israel sang this song to the Lord.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. I will sing to the Lord for his victory. Horse and chariot cast in the sea. I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord my God, the God of my fathers I extol. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. The Lord is mighty indeed. The Lord is a mighty warrior. He has conquered all our foes. He has cast down the foe. He has cast down the horse and chariot in the waters of the Red Sea. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. covered with water, the waters of the flood. They sank to the depths like a stone. Your right hand and arm, magnificent in power, Lord our God, shattered the foe. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. You brought forth your people, the people of redemption, in the mountain of your throne, where you built a home, where you built a sanctuary. The Lord shall reign forevermore. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God on high. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God
on high. Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from the Pharaoh's persecution. By the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, the God of hosts, your maker is your husband. The Lord of hosts is his name. The Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer. The God of the whole earth he is called. For the Lord has called you like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, like the wife of a man's youth when she is cast off, says your God. For a brief moment I abandon you, but with great compassion I will gather you. In overflowing wrath for a moment I hid my face from you, but with everlasting love I will have compassion on you, says the Lord your Redeemer. This is like the days of Noah to me, just as I swore that the waters of Noah would never again go over the earth, so I have sworn that I will not be angry with you and will not rebuke you. For the mountains may depart and the hills be removed, but my steadfast love shall not depart from you, and my covenant of peace shall not be removed, says the Lord who has compassion on you. O afflicted one, storm-tossed and not comforted, I am about to set your stones in antimony and lay your foundations with sapphires. I will make your pinnacles of rubies, your gates of jewels, and all your walls of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the prosperity of your children. In righteousness you shall be established. You shall not far from oppression, for you shall not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, Lord. You have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord. You have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, Lord. You have rescued me and have not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you have raised my soul from the dead, restored me to life from those who sink to the grave. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. Sing psalms to the Lord, you who love him. Give thanks to his holy name. His anger lasts but a moment, his favor through life. At night there are tears, but joy comes with dawn. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord. The Lord listened and had pity. The Lord came to my help. For me you have changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, I will thank you forever. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for your mercy. I will praise you, Lord, you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, surpass for the honor of your name what you pledged to the patriarchs by reason of their faith, and through sacred adoption increase the children of your promise, so that what the saints of old never doubted would come to pass. Your church, may now see in great part fulfilled, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth is the people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. We do mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth is the people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth is to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth is to people of goodwill.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Jesus was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in the newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died for sin once and for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, Alleluia. 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 Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Steadfast love endures forever. Alleluia. 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 The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. Recount the deeds of the Lord. Alleluia. 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 The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. Marvelous in our eyes. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. The Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you're looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And indeed, he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him." This is my message for you. So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Everyone knows the meaning of Good Friday. It is a day when we remember that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. The same is true of Easter Sunday, when we celebrate that he rose from the dead in triumph over death. But what about Holy Saturday? Though it may have been a day of waiting for his disciples, Jesus was engaged in some of his most dramatic and important work of his messianic mission, and it took him to the depths of hell. It's there in the Apostles' Creed. He was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. And the third day, he rose again from the dead. The question is, if Jesus is God, who is all good, why would he go into hell? I've been asked by some few parishioners about this after some of our Sunday masses, which is kind of inconvenient because there's not enough time to explain when you're greeting parishioners. Usually, I just tell them to call me for an appointment, but they never called. So if you're listening here tonight, listen. To properly understand what's going on here, there are two things you need to know. First, when most people hear the word hell, they think of hell, that is, of the damned, the hell of the damned, the place of eternal punishment for people who do not die in Christ. However, the term hell can sometimes have a broader meaning of the realm of the dead for those who are not experiencing the vision of God. So it's the realm of the dead. It's not just, you know, a place of damnation. It was during those times in which people who died before Christ have to go somewhere. And that's why they have to go to this place, the realm of the dead. This broader meaning certainly includes the hell of the damned, but can also include other places, for example, purgatory, as a part of the broader realm of the dead, but is separate from hell of the damned. Second, before the coming of Christ, there was at least one other part of the realm of the dead that no longer exists. A place called Limbo of the Patriarchs. It only existed before the coming of Christ. If before Christ a person died in friendship with God, they wouldn't go to hell of the damned to be punished. But they also couldn't go to heaven because Christ had not yet made that possible for us. Instead, they went to a place of the realm of the dead without the punishments of the damned. That Jesus visited when he descended into hell. As the Catechism of the Catholic Church explains, Jesus did not descend into hell to deliver the damned, nor to destroy the hell of damnation, but to free the just who had gone before him. So after dying on the cross, Jesus descended to the realm of the dead to proclaim to them that he had won their salvation and to lead them as the first entrance into heaven. Traditionally, this has included people like Adam and Eve, Saint John the Baptist, and his foster father, Joseph. This is vitally important, but often forgotten part of Christ's mission, as described most beautifully in an ancient sermon for Holy Saturday. And here's part of it. He has gone to search for our first parent as for a lost sheep, greatly desiring to visit those who live in darkness and in the shadow of death. He has gone to free from sorrow the captives, Adam and Eve, he who is both God and son of Eve. The Lord approached them bearing the cross, the weapon that had won him victory. At the side of him, Adam, the first man he had created, struck his breast in terror and cried out to everyone, "My Lord be with you all." Christ answered him, "And with your spirit." He took him by the hand and raised him up, saying, "Awake, O sleeper, and rise from the dead, and Christ will give you light. I do not create you to be held prisoner in hell. Rise from the dead, for I am the life of the dead." So don't let Holy Saturday just be a day between Good Friday and Easter Sunday. Rather, contemplate Christ's dramatic rescue mission in the realm of the dead and praise God. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water that he has created, which will be sprinkled upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May he graciously renew us that we may remain faithful to the Spirit whom we have received. Lord God, in your mercy, be present to your people who keep vigil on this most sacred night. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our salvation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water, for you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched the thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupt nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten of servants is concluded, let us renew the baptismal promises for which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? I do. Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? I do. Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus for eternal life.
Springs of water, bless the Lord, give him glory and praise forever. Springs of water, bless the Lord, give him glory and praise forever. Give him glory and praise forever. Springs of water, bless the Lord, give him glory and praise forever.
Prayers of the faithful. With exultation and joy, we proclaim that Christ is risen, and that through him we can now offer our prayers to the Father.
For the Holy Catholic Church throughout the world, that she may grow this night in the risen life of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the light of the risen Christ may shine upon the poor, the afflicted, the hungry, the homeless, and the unborn. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unity of families, for whoever mourns spouse or child, parent, relative, friend, for the unemployed, the homeless, the addicted, and the imprisoned, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the world during this coronavirus pandemic, healing for the sick, eternal repose for the deceased, and strength for all those bringing medical and pastoral care to the sick. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters who are sick, Edison Bonifacio, Benvenido David, Christine Souza, Joseph Souza, Joe Silva, Marcelo Oliveiro, and all the sick in our community, that God will give them consolation, strength, and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters who have died, Claudia Enverzo, Joyce Jose, Molly Rahamat, Kevin Joseph Berry, Petra Furman Jaglal, Rogelio Benigno, Fatima Fernando, and all our faithful departed, that they may be welcomed into eternal joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our personal intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant us, Father, to live in the light of the risen Christ and to share his light with many until his return to glory, who lives and reigns with you now and forever. Amen.
453.
Christ is alive and goes before us to show and share what love can do. This is a day of new beginnings. Our God is making all things new. Our God is making all things new. This is the day of new beginnings. Time and move on. Time to believe what love is bringing, laying to rest the pain that's gone. Christ is alive and goes before us to show and share what love can do. This is a day of new beginnings. Our God is making all things new. Our God is making all things new. For by the life and death of Jesus, love's mighty spirit now as then can make for us a world of difference as faith and hope are born again. Christ is alive, goes before us to show and share what love can do. This is a day of new beginnings. Our God is making all things new. Our God is making all things new. Then let us with the Spirit's daring step from the past and leave behind our disappointment, guilt, and grieving, seeking new paths and sure to find. Christ is alive, goes before us to show and share what love can do. This is a day of new beginnings. Our God is making all things new. Our God is making all things new.
The people.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, who is the true eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as a memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When
and we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed
be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
You, everybody, is with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, O Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Thank you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Grant us your peace. Grant us your
peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. And the bread we break, it is a sharing in the body of the Lord. How can we make a return for all the goodness God has shown? We will take the cup of life,
the body of
and call upon God's name. Our blessing cup is a and the bread we break, it is a sharing in the body of the Lord. Precious indeed in your sight, the life and death of those you we are your peace servants, for you have set us free. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. And the bread we break, it is a sharing in the body of the Lord. Gracious and merciful God, we give you thanks and bless your name. With all your people, praise and glory to your name. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. And the bread we break, it is a sharing in the body of the
Lord. Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have some announcements. Please be seated. First of all, I'd like to thank those who have participated in our Holy Week celebrations here, the lectors who were here, and also the cantors who were here. It added more to the meaning and solemnity of the celebration. I know it's different, celebrating something like this. It's, for me, something new, and we don't know if we were actually looking good to you while doing our celebrations here, but if you want to give us some comments and suggestions, it's welcome, so that as we continue doing this, we'll continue to improve in our celebrations. So also, thank you, David and Mary, who's here, and Mike, Uche, they're here tonight, and Father Anish for working hard on this celebrations, and our masses, and our liturgy, decorating, and at the same time preparing, you know, whatever needs to be prepared. So, in other words, we didn't have our usual people who helps us, people who would help us here in church. So we were doing it ourselves. We're thinking of buying some flowers, you know, things like that, but we just made do with whatever was available to us. So thank you for watching us and attending the celebrations. Thank you to everyone. And just to remind you, tomorrow we have two masses for Easter Sunday, one at 10 o'clock, then the other at 12 noon. So hopefully you can tell the others to attend the celebration. And so what, did I miss anything? Nothing? Okay, I didn't miss anything. Usually I do. And maybe the prayer, the act of spiritual communion, that's something that you have to pray today, which I don't have here also. Anyways, you just pray on your own. Now please stand for the solemn blessing. Bow your heads. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in His compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. Amen. And may He who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of His only begotten Son endow you with the prize of immortality. Amen. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
Happy Easter.
Easter,
happy
Father.
Easter, happy Easter, everybody, happy Easter.
452.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. I will give thanks to you, my Lord. You have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death. You are my strength and my song. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth be yours. Holy, 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 heaven and earth are full of your glory. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Thank you. Very good, wonderful, as always.
I'm sorry about the exalted.
The exalted, the wilderness around them. My voice can be good.
Thank you, Father. I won't leave anything behind tonight. Happy Easter again, Father. See you.
Tomorrow. So this one is the reading.
see resurrection, Mass of Easter Day. Leave it there.
My name is Anish. First and foremost, I wish you all blessed and happy Easter. I believe you all are keeping well by the grace of God, and we pray for the same. The other day we celebrated the Good Friday. Our Savior and Lord died on the cross to save you. Same suffering growth is bringing us numerous blessings to the resurrection of Jesus, especially on the day of Easter. Easter is not something that is happening once in a year, not parish or in the church, but it's happening every day in our life. When I smile at someone with joyful heart who hurts me, when I take initiative to help the one who gives me often pain, struggles, and hard time, when I feed hungry birds or animals in my backyard and try to love the creatures, when I pour some one drop of love to a plant or tree that is about to die and love the nature, during the sickness, pain, struggle, hardships, instead of cursing, dying, situation and God, when I stand strong and firm in my faith, trusting in His providence and mercy, dear friends, in all these occasions and moments, we enter into an Easter experience, where Jesus' resurrection is happening again and again to me by love. The resurrection experience is not meant to return to our old way of life, but to forget everything that is old. Let us celebrate Easter with joyful heart. Dear Sinan's family, we are praying for you every day. Please give us your prayers. Stay home and stay safe, because we love you and we want you to be back to our parish as early as possible. This is for us exciting and pleasant experience. We are like shepherds without sheep. Hope to see you more soon, and we pray for that. Take care.
you will remember it. So when you read